first, I will say sorry for my English. After your talking, I'm very, very bad English, and I will be only read. Thank you for your understanding. Allow me to greet all participants of the third conference, the Tibetan Medicine. My report is intended to briefly introduce you to the history of Tibetan medicine in Russia. I want to note that in recent years, Tibetan medicine is a high demand in our country and enjoys great interest not only by patients but also by the professional medical community. Traditional medicine for the Buryats, customs of healing. Traditional medicine of the Buryat people has no written sources. It is long been customary that it is transferred from the one carrier of the culture to another. In modern scientific literature, there are very few materials on national medicine of the Buryats. However, from the available historical sources, it is known that the following medical practices can be distinguished in Buryat folk medicine: shamanic treatment, bone setting, manual therapy, and treatment with herbal, animal, and mineral origin medicine. Up to now, basically, we have learned the knowledge of the bone setting techniques with which everything associated within the Buryat folk medicine. The main features of the Buryat folk medicine are the characteristic for the medical traditions of nomadic peoples, namely the use of mainly external non-medicament means of treatment, bone setting, massage, rolfing, vacuum therapy, and o cupping. This is explained not only by the nomadic way of life, but also by continuous wars in those periods, constant movements across regions with different composition of flora, obviously were the reasons of the lack of accumulations of written literature in the use of plant products. The healers of such conditions had to rely more and raw materials from domestic and commercial animals and their hands. Historical materials covering the spread of Buddhism and Tibetan traditional medicine date of the first information in the middle of the 16th and 7th centuries, related to the official exceptions of Lamaism as the state religions. Already the beginning of the 18th century in Transbaikalia, there were skilled healers who used the whole range in medicine and methods of Tibetan medicine and had practiced among the population. The first doctors were Tibetan missionaries. They tried to teach their art to students the Buryat heritage. The first head of the Buryat lamas was Tibetan Gagwan Puntsok, was known as a good healer. And the first doctor from the Buryats, whose name was well established, Zhimba Akhalaev, who studied in Mongolia and in Tibet. His successor, another well-known Buddhist monk, Lama Damba Dorji Zayaev, also received education in Tibet. The son of the Buryat steppes, a doctor of the Russian Emperor Peter Badmaev. Tibetan medicine became very popular in Tsarist Russia at the end of the 19th century, thanks to two Buryat brothers, MC healers, Tibetan medicine doctors, Sultim and Jamsaran Badmaev. However, more active political, social, and scientific activities in the popularization of the Tibetan medicine were carried by Peter Jamsaran Badmaev. He was the youngest son on the cattle breeder whose family was linked to the Chinggis Khan descendant through the female line. To become a doctor, young Jamsaran decided after his older brother Sultim, who was an MC Lama, Tibetan physician. Therefore, after graduating from the gymnasium, Jamsaran went to St. Petersburg to his brother, who at the time already owned a pharmacy and was practicing Tibetan medicine. In St. Petersburg, was brothers adopt orthodoxy. Sultim took the name Alexander and Jamsaran Peter is the honor of Tsar Peter the First. In St. Petersburg, Peter Badmaev graduated from the Faculty of Oriental Studies of St. Petersburg University and the Medical and Surgical Academy. It should be notes that at the end of the Medical Surgical Academy, he decided not to receive a diploma because the graduate had to take on an oath that will treat patients, but standardized European scientific methods. But Badmaev decided to devote himself to Tibetan medicine. Having graduated from both educational institutions, this son of the Buryat steppes became one of the most highly educated people of his time. The history of the first clinic of Tibetan medicine in Russia, Naran. In 1989, the history of our clinics began. Also, the idea of this creation was much earlier. I was motivated to pursue Tibetan medicine by the practice as a Western doctor. As a young specialist talking to the patients and on a daily basis, I very soon realized that conventional medical education was not sufficient for effective treatment of patients, and I began to search for alternative therapies. I studied literature on Buddhism and Tibetan medicine, took over experience from Buryat Lamas, MC Lamas. It was not easy because many sages were lost. The bearers of knowledge were repressed or emigrated to other countries, Mongolia, China. My brother, Bayir Chojinimayev, also doctor of Tibetan medicine, support me to my professional searches. Ну, это я тут пропущу. Скажу немножечко, потому что очень не хочу задерживать ваше внимание. Sorry, можешь перевести. People accepted Tibetan medicine because this medical science was cultivated for centuries. It is long traditional, which is described in the well-known ancient medical treatise. We studied those textbooks and combined that knowledge with Western medical experience. Now our clinic has 8 branches, 4 in Moscow, 2 in St. Petersburg, 1 in Kazan, and 1 in Ekaterinburg. In Austria, my nephew, the doctor of Tibetan medicine, Vitaly Radnaev, opened his own practice. The staff of the clinic Naran are professional doctors of modern Western medicine who have been trained in the educational center in our clinic and the addition educational courses in the specialist reflexology and neurology in medical universities. All of them are ethnic representative of nomadic peoples who studied and practiced Tibetan medicine, Buryats, Mongols, Kalmyks, Korean, Chinese. For the first time in Russia, we began to treat our patients according to the principles of Tibet medical science. All diseases are divided into two types, diseases of heat and cold. At the heart of treatment of our patients is the basic rule of the theory of Tibetan medicine regarding the division of people into three groups. There are the types of people who are divided according to the constitutions or dosha Ayurvedic approach: wind, slime, and bile. As you know, in European classification of Hippocrates, he distinguished four types of people: phlegmatic, melancholic, choleric, and sanguinized. This division is based on a certain similarity in these groups of physical and psycho-emotional states of a person. In Tibetan medicine, in education to these properties, psychological and pathopsychological features directly related to the lifestyle and nutritional characteristic of this group of people are also taken into account. Changes the occur both in the external environment, climate, weather, season, type, biorhythms, and the internal state of the person related to A. The state of nervous system, wind, lung, Tibet, vata, Ayurvedic, emotional, stress resistance, mental trauma, and so on. B. With the nature of nutrient internal in each individual and connected directly with this process in constitutions, the system dosha, bile, pitta, Ayurvedic, mkhris, Tibetan. The slime, Batkan, Tibet, Kapha, Ayurvedic. All practitioners of Tibetan medical medicine interested the terminology and understand the causes of human disease, a cause of the disruption of this human regulatory system. But unfortunately, doctors of allopathic medicine who continue to treat patients pathogenically do not understand this approach, treating the symptoms and syndromes but not root cause, following a rigid standard of treatment. In modern medicine, a rather conservative approach remains in the treatment of chronic human disease such as diabetes, hypertension, cerebral and cardiac ischemia, bronchopulmonary diseases, tumor process, and neuropsychopathic states. Allopathic medicine is not always effective, and often patients get addicted to taking medications for a prolonged period of time. But complete recovery for moderate pathologies does not occur. The clinic Naran for 20 years has proved the high effectiveness of methods of Tibetan medicine due to the successful results of our patients. Now, combining the knowledge of modern, Western, and ancient Tibetan medicine, it's possible to create practice that will continue on for centuries. Thank you so much for your attention. Thank you. But this is my first report on English. Thank you. Sorry.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.